A man who wanted to open a museum honoring Adolf Hitler gets a no from Walworth County.
Museum should be prosecuted. He claims he was an SS officer and built the museum in honor of Adolf Hitler.
We demand justice. We demand justice. We demand justice.
This video and its purpose is only to document a part of Wisconsin history and its relationship with a hateful group. We do not support or trying to promote their views or delusional ideas. The Holocaust did happen, taking at least 6 million Jewish lives. Urban exploring can be extremely dangerous. Please do not attempt without proper knowledge of where you are going and what you are doing. Always be aware of the ramifications. Please enjoy the video. Theodore Junker was born April 13th, 1919 in Romania, moving to Germany, 1940, and in 1995, moving to Chicago, Illinois, in the United States, later buying a small farm near Millard, Wisconsin. In 2006, however, the Chicago Tribune published a story by Courtney Flynn and Dan Gibbards that stated, "Retired farmer, Southeast Wisconsin, has built a memorial to Adolf Hitler, hoping to spread his admiration." It was Theodore, now going by Ted, 87 years old. Though he had agreed not to hold a grand opening as planned, Junker wanted people to visit the shrine he had created. He kept doors open with cinder blocks, hoping likewise members would flock. Outrage was felt by the community and Jewish leaders around the area. Fear that the neo-Nazi and white supremacists glorifying Hitler would begin to make the spot a place for pilgrimage, a restraining order was put on for the public. Ted spent his last days on the property before passing in 2013 of April. In 2021, the remains of their abandoned property still lies deep in Wisconsin forest. As explorers, we have taken the duty to explore and document what remains a dark part of Wisconsin history. We started the day with a 2-mile hike through the uncut and messy forest.
Doing good?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We're gonna go down this way, okay, guys?
Okay. After wandering through the fields and forest, we eventually made it to the outskirts of the property, where a giant eye in the middle of the lake stared back at us. Upon to the left, we were met with a shrine, now in disrepair, the window smashed out, the doors hanging off, everything overgrown. Broken sentences with the letters falling off. Upon entering the building, there was a deafening silence. No wildlife could be heard, only the wind.
Initial thoughts were pretty much the same as any other abandoned building we typically explore. Trash and clutter swallowing any open space. It wasn't until the back wall hit my eyes and the line that stuck out the most to me was, "Not one person was gassed to death in the Third Reich." At this point forward, I turned really cold and couldn't formulate any words, just continued to register all the madness and craziness that surrounded us. Internally, I was asking, am I in a bad movie? Does this really exist 35 minutes away from my house? People really gathered here under Nazi ideals?
It's pretty terrifying.
There's more writing and more information on top of the roof.
Oh yeah.
So we need to find a way up onto there, if that's possible.
Oh wow. There's a whole shrine up here.
The rooftop was the most terrifying of any place we went to that day.
This memorial is for everyone who was persecuted from the genocide, and then right below this they have a whole room just dedicated to Hitler and talking about how amazing he was. It makes no sense.
In disbelief from the ignorance we had just witnessed, we decided to check out the house to see if there was any clues or information more about Ted or maybe other people that had stayed on the property.
Area. A lot. Dishware. New order of the... Yeah. I mean, what do you expect from this type of place?
With not much in good condition on the first floor, we headed to the second. Again, there wasn't much. Plates, bowls, other utensils littered the floor, along with pornographic magazines and videos. The wood floor we walked on creaked and moaned underneath us, with each step feeling like we were about to fall through.
Someone like Ted creating a monument to one of history's most disgusting tragedies, it's a reviled initiative to the tragedy of all the lives that were lost. It's important to remember that we still live in a world that is home to many misinformed people who share Ted's beliefs. Wisconsin alone is home to 15 known hate groups, including anti-Muslim groups, neo-Nazis, anti-LGBT, black nationalist, and white nationalist organizations. Remember to treat others with respect and love, and always kindness. We hope you enjoyed this video, and please let us know in the comments below what you thought. Until next time, go explore.